There's a giant cloud of alcohol out there in space just floating there teasing me. Is that the only way we're gonna be able to drink in space? Not quite. Happy Friday, comrades. Trace here for D-News. 6,500 light years away, a giant cloud of alcohol is just hanging out. Alcohol is a mix of hydrogen, carbon, and oxygen, three extremely abundant elements in our universe. So to find it out there isn't that surprising. Finding it, though, has astronomers excited because the cloud of alcohol has the exact conditions required to trigger an astrophysical maser. It's a real thing. It's like a laser, but instead of light, it's microwaves. It actually came before lasers. The people who wouldn't be excited about it are pretty much everybody else because the cloud is made of methyl alcohol, which is not the kind you can drink. But there is hope. NASA cares deeply about the psychological health of astronauts, and a cold, frothy beverage is a great way to keep astronauts mentally anchored to Earth. So, what about having a drink in space? Well, for NASA astronauts, it's not really on the table. We've talked a bit about this in the past. NASA has a pretty strict alcohol policy on the ISS and on the shuttle missions. Space is dangerous, so being less than sober could cause injury or death. That being said, NASA researched a sherry wine to go up on Skylab in the 70s, but it never actually went into space. Turns out the smell of wine in microgravity made people nauseated during testing, and the astronauts on short-term missions didn't really care if they had alcohol or not. After one astronaut made a public speech saying they were looking into it, angry letters prompted NASA to ban alcoholic beverages altogether. The Russians, on the other hand, very famously had cognac on Mir and supposedly were rationed about 4 ounces per day. Supposedly. There is some science to support alcohol in space. A 2011 paper found resveratrol, a component of some alcohols, can prevent significant bone density, muscle, and metabolic losses during spaceflight. Even though the astronauts can't wet their whistles, that doesn't mean that there isn't science to be had. A Scottish whisky distillery named Ardbeg shot 20 test tubes into space to test the effects of microgravity on whisky terpenes back in 2011. A terpene is an organic molecule that's part of whisky maturation. It's a naturally occurring hydrocarbon that can be found in termites, butterflies, hop plants, pine tar, and even paint thinners. It helps give whisky its flavor. When the space-matured whisky lands, it will be tested against control whisky molecules that have been chilling here on Earth for 3 years to learn more about how distilling works. And it wasn't just whiskey either. Experiments have been done to explore how yeast behave in fermentation in space, how foam and bubbles behave in space, and even how a gas-liquid mixture would behave in microgravity. Turns out beer doesn't actually work in space, nor does any other carbonated beverage really. Coca-Cola did partner with a company called BioServe, and they tried it out on the space shuttle, and it worked kind of okay. The word they used was palatable. Do you think astronauts should be able to have a glass of wine with their rehydrated dinner? Should we let them get wasty face up there? What would you want in space? Have a cold one and spill your thoughts into the comments right here. We want to hear them. And check out my and Tara's other show, Test Tube, where we break down politics, world events, and curiosity about complicated news, like this one on whether we can trust the Russian media.
This year, two news anchors, one in the UK and one in the US, quit their jobs at Russian-run television networks because they were no longer willing to pass off false information and other Russian propaganda as news.
Thanks for watching D-News, everybody. Please subscribe.